Hi, my name is Navjot. In this video, I will discuss how instrument plugins can be developed for OpenTap. Here's a quick look at the OpenTap architecture. OpenTap incorporates a plugin-based architecture that extends its core functionality. Instrument plugins allow OpenTap to configure, interact with, and perform operations on instruments. Now let's walk through the development of a simple instrument plugin. In this example, we will create an instrument communication plugin for a Keysight spectrum analyzer. However, OpenTap instrument plugins are hardware vendor agnostic, which means you can create plugins for instruments made by any vendor, including Keysight. So to work through this example, I'm going to use our shipping examples project. In the shipping examples project, let's have a look at the Skippy instrument example. First, to create an instrument plugin, we will add a new class for our instrument. This can be done by using the Add New Item from the Project Context menu in Visual Studio. From the New Item menu, we will select OpenTap Instrument. In this case, I am using the instrument class provided in the shipping examples. Note that our instrument class derives from the Skippy Instrument base class. The base class provides some basic instrument settings such as visa address, visa configuration, methods to communicate with the instrument, among other things. Let's have a closer look at the structure of our instrument class. The open method is automatically invoked just before the test plan starts execution, and it can be used to initialize the instrument, create communication handles, and so on. In this case, we compare the instrument identity string with the predefined string subset value. This approach can be used to restrict the instrument class to operate with specific instrument models. Close is invoked just after the test plan completes execution. Close method can be used to cleanly close the connection to the instrument, dispose of instrument communication handles, among other things. Any other operations on the instruments are performed using custom methods. In this example, we will add two custom methods, configure and sweep measurement. Configure method will be used to apply configuration settings on the spectrum analyzer instrument. Inside the configure method, we have Skippy calls to set up center frequency, frequency span, and the number of waveform trace points. The sweep measurement method will be used to acquire the spectrum trace from the spectrum analyzer instrument. Inside this method, we have just one Skippy query that returns the waveform trace data points. Now our instrument plugin has been completed. We can invoke or use this instrument in a test step and perform operations on it. This concludes this video. I hope you found it useful. Thanks for watching.